This weekend, rain and storms making a big splash in the eastern and the western U.S. Cars sloshing through flooding in downtown Los Angeles. The city notching its wettest July on record, and more rain is on the way.
And look at what the powerful floodwaters did in Arizona. They picked up sheds and cars and slammed them into bridges. As much as 5 inches of rain yesterday. Learn how much more the monsoon could unleash today.
In the eastern half of the U.S., the fuse about to be lit on an explosive new round of strong storms. The threat area stretching a staggering 1,800 miles from Wichita to Chicago to Buffalo. Who will get hit with what and when? Next.
Something's wrong. I don't know what's happening, but baby, it's too hot out here. H-H-O-T-T.
Well, the heat's going to be so brutal today, we might have to change that to H-H-H-O-T-T-T. 73 million people under alerts. Cities from Myrtle Beach to Hartford in for their hottest day of the year. Right here, right now on Weekend Recharge.
Good morning to you and welcome to Weekend Recharge. I'm Maria LaRosa.
And I'm Alex Walls in for Paul Goodlow. Now, if you think we're having an unusually stormy July in some parts of the country, you're right. Mm-hmm. The storm reports continue to pile up, more than 140 yesterday, and that stretched from California to Virginia.
Yeah, California is the crazy one, right? But Chicago, another one of those cities in line for another round of strong storms today. Check out the lightning, though, that lit up the city skyline yesterday. Fans at the Pitchfork Festival in Union Park in the northwest side of town had to be evacuated for a time. A possible tornado hit the community of Harvard. That's about 70 miles northwest of Chicago.
And those storms then blasted into southwest Michigan. Maria here. John Baker actually tweeting this picture of the ominous skies over Union Pier. A sinister looking shelf cloud there. Now notice the people just sort of hanging around, chilling on the beach, watching the storms. Well, if you see clouds like this today, get inside immediately. Maria has the details in your Sunday snapshot.
Absolutely. Getting your recharge for the week ahead with the snapshot. And actually, a lot of us could see scenes like that. I mean, take a look at the severe risk all the way from Colorado on up to Maine. It's the damaging winds and heavy rain, all a threat. We'll talk about the timing. And then, of course, the heat already settled in across the south, now really nosing its way into the northeast with heat advisories and excessive heat warnings also in effect. And then monsoon, not just the flash flood, but another threat for thunderstorms in Southern California. We'll time this out and what it means for the heavy rain threat today and tomorrow. That's coming up. But first, Alex, you have more on that severe threat.
Yeah, absolutely. We've certainly been dealing with a stormy weekend from the plains, and we're going to watch that move into New England. A live look at St. Louis, and this is a spot that's in the crosshairs, so watch out. Severe threat is there. Damaging wind, rain, hail, all a possibility. Are we already seeing some showers and storms trying to move on through the north side of town? There's more action off towards the north and west, and then here we are, another cluster moving through the northern portion of the state of Missouri. This action here, remember, looks very similar to what we were dealing with yesterday right around this time, this big cluster here that was marching its way across the northern part of the state. Heavy rain and the lightning strikes. That heavy rain has actually prompted several flash flood warnings east of the Kirksville area. This is for Knox County. That does include you in Greensburg. Until 2:15, you've got a flash flood warning there, and it's still raining, so watch out. In Novelty here, we're talking rainfall accumulation getting up over 3 inches. So, yeah, a lot of rain coming down into these areas, prompting some of those flash flood warnings. So the city of St. Louis, seeing some of that rain again north side of town. Several reports north of you, they're just south of Springfield in the Gillespie area. Again, more rainfall accumulating, getting above 3 inches. So decent amounts of rain here. Got to be careful if you see ponding on the roads. Turn around, don't drown. So let's follow our front. This is where our storms are sort of following along here as we head through the rest of the day, marching through the Midwest. The front will continue to head its way through the Great Lakes as well, and eventually sparks off some storms here in the interior northeast. And eventually late tonight, we could see some of that activity move its way towards that 95 corridor. So that'll be a zone of potential storms, as well as back towards the plains. States in the Midwest here, stretching here across Kansas into Missouri along Interstate 70. Wind, hail, and can't rule out the isolated tornado. Then, of course, Maria, we've got some heat.
Yeah, it's only getting more intense in a city like Dallas today. You should hit 100 degrees for the first time this year, and then you'll stay there for most of the upcoming week. Interestingly enough, Dallas not under a heat advisory. So a lot like winter weather advisories and storm warnings and that kind of thing, it's a criteria that's not exactly the same everywhere. But with that said, it's still dangerous and possibly deadly heat, even in Dallas, but certainly where we have the heat advisories, Memphis, Jackson, New Orleans, Macon, St. Louis, and it's making its way into the Northeast too. Here's a look at where we could be today with that heat index, 108 in Memphis. We got 105 peak heat index in Oklahoma City, even on into tomorrow where that white hot pink is. That's where you've got those heat index values close to 100 degrees. And as we often say, it's not just where it peaks, but how long it lasts. And you still see that's the case well into Tuesday, although you start to see some of that relief coming in, and that's going to be one of the big stories into the Northeast. But Alex, between now and then, they have their fair share of dangerous heat.
Yeah, sure do, no doubt. So it's not just relegated to parts of the South. We're dealing with it here. In fact, look at all the heat advisories in place. East Coast, excessive heat warning there for you in Philadelphia. Highs today, 89 Pittsburgh, 96 in D.C., up to 88 in Boston. Some of these spots, the hottest day of the year. Apparently, it's National Ice Cream Day, so it's a good day to go grab some ice cream to stay cool. Look at these feel-like temperatures here in D.C., 100-plus for several hours. It's not until we get until around 9 o'clock where we'll drop below 100 in terms of how it feels like out there. Philadelphia for you as well, several hours, not until the evening. So that's the key. If you have to do the exercising, I know you're trying to stay in shape, keep it to the early morning, late in the evening when it's not as hot. Tomorrow, still very hot here along the East Coast. It's the interior that starts to cool down, particularly by Tuesday. That's going to feel nice. 70s from Buffalo down to Pittsburgh, and here along the East Coast, not as hot, but still quite warm. Maria?
Alex, when we return, Southern California deals with a dual threat, fire and rain. In Los Angeles, historic rainfall already for July. But despite the rain, wildfires are still spreading across the region. We will tell you where all this rain is coming from and if it will move north to help with the state's drought.
Going out for date night with your man is nice. But I think women would agree, snuggling up after is kind of nice too. But here's the thing. About half of men over 40 have some degree of erectile dysfunction. Well, Viagra helps guys with ED get and keep an erection.
Ask your doctor if your heart is healthy enough for sex. Do not take Viagra if you take nitrates for chest pain. It may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Side effects include headache, flushing, upset stomach, and abnormal vision. To avoid long-term injury, seek immediate medical help for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. Stop taking Viagra and call your doctor right away if you experience a sudden decrease or loss in vision or hearing.
Ask your doctor about Viagra.
Now available in new single packs.
Nice job, guys. And don't worry, this beauty will last and last because I'm the only pain primer in one with easy wash formula, which you may find pretty handy someday.
Olympic One Paint with exclusive easy wash formula stands up to 1,500 scrubs. Olympic, simply done. Exclusively at Lowe's. Stop by Lowe's and save $5 on Olympic exterior paints and stains. Just another way Olympic makes it easy every step of the way.
Why would you need a backpack that's backed by a guarantee? LL Bean Backpacks. Guaranteed for all the things life and kids throw their way. Designed smarter, built tougher.
To do a commercial with a Dodge and not do a burnout?
What's this?
A box. It takes worn out things and makes them better.
It's our biggest breakthrough yet. We're taking worn out batteries and making them into something strong. Energizer Eco Advanced, world's first long lasting battery made with 4% recycled batteries.
It's your thing.
See results in just 1 week with SlimFast. Shake it off.
Blend it off. Just take it off and keep it off. Rich, protein-packed Slim Fast controls hunger up to 4 hours. Slim Fast, it's your thing.
Monday morning, heavy summer rains bring out the snakes. Which ones are dangerous and do you know the difference? Plus, the forecast to start your week Monday on AMHQ.
Currently in our area, 88 degrees under fair skies. Partly cloudy. A stray afternoon or evening thunderstorm is possible. High 89. Tonight, scattered thunderstorms early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Winds south at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Time to sweat, boys. Big time.
Let's get this thing right.
Episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, tonight at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
We were really scared. There was people crying, kids crying.
Very tough, scary, because we see the fires behind us. We tried to run in, and thanks God we find a woman. She helped us.
The car was parked on the outside edge when the fire hit it. It burnt all the side, the back, cooler.
Survivors of that freeway firestorm in California recalling the horrifying moments as flames overtook their cars on Interstate 15 between Los Angeles and Las Vegas.
At least 20 cars were lost in the inferno, but amazingly, no lives were lost.
And that is amazing when you see those pictures. Well, fire just one of a multitude of threats facing California. Heavy rain could trigger a new round of flooding and high surf and increasing rip currents, a threat from Dolores. Now, the North Fire in San Bernardino County, California, burning across 3,500 acres. It's 60% contained as of this morning.
Now, gusty winds pushed this fire onto Interstate 15 Friday, burning 20 vehicles. Certainly a frightening moment, but everyone safely escaped.
All right, let's bring in Lee Beyer with the U.S. Forest Service. Any new preventative measures along I-15 to prevent this type of thing from happening again? It seemed like it happened so quickly.
Yeah, it did happen very quickly. This fire started, moved very rapidly up and over that southbound lane and then continued up into the Baldy Mesa area.
Thunderstorms are possible again today. Is that a good thing? Is it a bad thing? We know, I mean, that means lightning, that means gusty winds.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a mixed blessing. The rains are certainly beneficial. The increased humidity helps put the fire down. With it comes, though, the possibility of some heavier rain, mud flows, and, of course, new lightning strikes, both in the area and also the impacts to folks on the ground nearby.
Now, Lee, I know drones can get a great picture and overview of what is happening, but we understand they were flying over some of the areas on Friday, and valuable time was actually lost. Talk about that.
Okay, yes. Yeah, there were 5 drones that were sighted over the fire kind of as this fire began. It's our understanding that they were up in the air before the fire started, just hobbyists flying their toys. What we did lose is about 25 minutes of time for our aircraft up in the air at the beginning stages of this fire. So, yeah, it's certainly a challenge and a problem for us.
That is something I didn't hear regarding the story. That's fascinating. All right, Lee Beyer with the U.S. Forest Service, thank you so much for taking time with us this morning. I mean, talk about something that now you have to consider these days.
Exactly, yeah.
And 20 minutes, that's a long time for a fire like that.
It prevented maybe some of those cars from being engulfed.
Wow. All right, let's take a closer look at California and the Southwest in particular. Let's remind you where that fire began in Southern California. There, right along Interstate 15, Cajon Pass. It's one of those busy interchanges. Kansas, a lot of railroad pathways through there as well. Obviously, it has been dry. We're talking about drought, but now we've had this moisture come in. And what's interesting is relative humidity is pretty high into the 70s here. And that's remarkable considering it's Southern California and how dry it's been. But we've had some tropical influence. We've been talking about that from what is now post-tropical cyclone Dolores and the monsoon, all of that coming together to feed in moisture. Now, as we mentioned with Lee, was talking about the good and the bad with the more showers and thunderstorms. Well, from Los Angeles to Las Vegas, Phoenix, Tucson, Albuquerque, there is that threat for more showers and thunderstorms. Some of it will be heavy, so pretty much everywhere where you saw the green, there is that threat for flash flooding. Something to keep in mind. We saw those incredible pictures out of Arizona over the last day or two with these houses just being washed away. So just be aware of that. Flagstaff, Tucson, San Diego, Los Angeles, even into Central California, the possibility of some showers, Santa Barbara included, even on into tonight. Keep that in mind. You see that the severe threat, maybe not as much, but certainly some gusty winds could be associated with these. Even on into tomorrow, you see on up into Los Angeles, into the Sierra Nevada mountains, and continuing in from, say, Flagstaff to Albuquerque. And as we've seen, a quick quarter of an inch is certainly enough to do the flash flooding there.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, still to come here on Weekend Recharge, places like New York City in line for some showers, maybe even a few thunderstorms a little bit later today.
So we're timing it all out for you with a look at what your Sunday afternoon has in store. And yeah, we'll take a peek at what your Monday morning rush might look like too. But for now, Times Square, you're looking good.
Packed indeed.
Hot
and humid. Oh, my goodness. You get down there in Times Square at this time of the year, it can be quite brutal.
Smells good too.
Before Mars, before the moon, we did the impossible again and again. Live the future of space travel at Exploration Space, one of thousands of exciting things to explore at Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex in Orlando. Always exploring.
Developing some of the highest quality nutrition isn't easy. So at GNC, why do we do it? Why do we work to deliver clinically studied products to fill the world's nutrition gaps? Why do we insist on the most stringent quality checks, period? Well, here's why. Celebrating 80 years of quality life and quality products. And we're just getting started. GNC.
Stop by your local GNC store today.
Can a protein originally found in a jellyfish improve your memory? Our scientists say yes. Researchers have discovered a protein that actually supports healthier brain function. It's the breakthrough in a supplement called Prevagen. As we age, we lose proteins that support our brain. Prevagen supplements these proteins and has been clinically shown to improve memory. It's safe and effective. For support of healthier brain function, a sharper mind, and clearer thinking, try Prevagen for yourself today.
Wherever it is you want to go, all you need to see is the next 200 feet. That's how life unfolds. A leap of faith. Even if you can't see it, your destination is out there. So just keep going, and you'll get there. 200 feet at a time. The Corolla. Toyota. Let's go places.
Before ISS. Before Hubble. We built the most extraordinary machine. Stand nose to nose with Space Shuttle Atlantis, one of thousands of exciting things to explore at Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex in Orlando. Always exploring.
Bop, 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 bop. Glad you're with us right here on AMHQ, the whole team.
Right, either go all in or just tap out.
Here we go. I told you, we're going to bust out of this drought.
As we say, keep watching with us this morning because we're all watching history happen together.
Bahamas Paradise Cruise Line, sailing from the Port of Palm Beach, has exciting cruise rates for Florida residents and visitors on multiple cruise dates with prices of just $149 for all interior cabins and just $169 for all ocean view cabins. You'll sail on Florida's newest, most flexible, and best Bahamas cruise. Your two-night cruise will include delicious dining, some of the best live shows at sea, lots of fun, lots of pampering, and an exciting day in the Bahamas. If you're looking for a longer vacation, add two or four nights at the all-inclusive, beautiful Grand Lucayan Resort to your cruise. Enjoy spectacular white sand beaches, family fun, fine dining, golf, and so much more. Call 800-814-7100 to book your Bahamas Paradise cruise from just $149 and let the summer vacation fun begin. That's 800-814-7100. 800-814-7100.
Monday morning, how long does it take to run the 2,100 miles of the Appalachian Trail? And what kind of weather do you face on a record-breaking run? Find out on Wake Up With Al, Monday morning at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 87 degrees, under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray afternoon or evening thunderstorm is possible. High 89. Tonight, scattered thunderstorm. Monday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Winds south at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
In Aurora, Colorado, a frightening day at a local park when lightning struck a tree near a swimming pool. Four teens were taken to a hospital and treated for minor injuries. No one was directly struck by lightning, but a day earlier, a hiker was killed and another seriously injured by lightning and a strike there on a nearby mountain.
I'll tell you, the lightning, really one of those dangers that can be prevented by staying inside, but there are five different ways that lightning can strike people. Here's the first one, a direct strike where you get basically what it says, directly struck by that lightning bolt.
And then is there a side flash where the lightning strikes a taller object nearby, a portion of that current then jumps to the person.
And we continue on here with number three, known as the ground current. So you get that strike, it actually travels through the ground, and if you're standing on it, well, you'll be struck, and this actually causes most lightning deaths as well as injuries.
And I think this surprises a lot of people, the conduction. Lightning can travel great distances through wires, plumbing, even other metal surfaces. That's why we say stay off the corded phones and stay away from, maybe hold off on that shower.
Exactly. And lastly, but not least, you've got the streamer, a little less common here, but basically you get these different streamers that sort of channel away from the main discharge, and those can also cause some issues. So all in all, lightning, a very dangerous thing. My wife makes fun of me all the time when I hear thunder and I start running to get inside.
You're that guy.
I don't mess around.
That everyone should follow. I don't either. I'm that mom too. I'm like, come on, let's go. But a lot of areas could see that. I mean, all the way from Colorado today to Maine, we have that storm threat.
Yeah, absolutely. There it is. And some of those could pack a bit of a punch. Anywhere in the red could be looking at severe storms.
And Louisville knows they're under the gun today for showers and thunderstorms. Heat advisory in effect until 8 o'clock tonight. So take precautions if you're heading out to the Forecastle Festival. There, too, also a chance for storms.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's the spot that saw it Friday night. Remember this? Crashing the festival with Sam Smith. He was performing and then had to stop mid-song. 60-mile-per-hour winds there. Pretty incredible that no one was injured.
They did it right. They got everyone out safely and calmly. That's good news. Louisville under the gun for severe weather again tomorrow. They're highlighted in red as well as much of the Ohio Valley. The Northeast, just hot.
Yeah, hot and humid. It's not going to be a fun time to get out and do too much activity outside. Boston for you. Watch out for that. Again, heat and humidity as we start to work our way to the early part of the week.
All right, so let's hit up Tuesday, and you do have those showers catching up with you, perhaps from Boston, Albany, down to Charleston, and swinging on back through the Rockies. I want to point out, though, Seattle, giving shout out to you. You're back in the 70s on Tuesday, before just after that hitting into the 90s.
Yeah, so. They've had some hot times. times there in the Pac Northwest, but now some relief.
Yeah, not so much in New Orleans. We kind of know that. Right. It stays hot this time of year. Looking live right now, you've got that sunshine. It is definitely steamy. And you've got that storm threat making a comeback from Tuesday into Wednesday, actually all along the Gulf Coast here, even as we get into Wednesday.
Looking a little more lively there in New Orleans than what it looked like an hour ago.
People
waking up now. Yeah. But here's Wednesday. More storms in the deep south. And it looks a lot worse than what it will be. It won't be all day drenching rains, but those storms begin to bubble up as we get into the afternoon. And of course, heavy downpours, the lightning issues, and a few that could be strong and severe.
All right, let's hit up Phoenix. And we know that this time of year, you get pretty hot. You're heading up into the hundreds, sizzling 100s, looking at some fair skies, but also getting a little bit of a break from the constant threat of thunderstorms here come by Thursday, actually much of the Southwest, even Southern California as well.
And look at the middle of the country. More storms to deal with here, right across the Mississippi, back into the deep south, Florida, your typical daily thunderstorms. We'll keep that going through the week.
All right, here comes Friday. Looks still great from the Great Lakes into the mid-Atlantic and the parts of the Northeast anyway. So from Chicago, Pittsburgh, New York, looking good in the 80s.
Man, I have to say, overall, over the next several days, it's the Great Lakes.
Yeah.
That's where you want to be.
All right, we take a peek at next weekend. You've got 87 a chance of storms from Chicago, still stormy across the southeast, still hot in Dallas. Your stretch there continues and remaining dry in the west and the southwest. We'll still head on Weekend Recharge. 73 million of us under the threat for some heat, Dallas included. Today, will you get your first 100 degree reading of the year? Stick around.
It's called Mother Nature for a reason. A nurturing spirit lives within every woman. At Mahindra, we strive to brighten the future for girls with a passion for agriculture. So thank you to the mothers and fathers of America for sharing the wonder of God's great outdoors. Today's future farmers are tomorrow's stewards of the land we care for.
The world's number one selling tractor. Visit MahindraUSA.com.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your doctor about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
Looks like the Garcias got a new car.
What'd they get?
I don't know.
Sure doesn't look like a Buick.
Buick.
I'm outside. Where are you?
I'm right here. I'm in the Buick.
I don't see a Buick.
Take a fresh look at Buick. It just might surprise you.
That's not a Buick. That's what I told him.
Wow. This is nice. Oh, my.
Now pay no interest for 5 years, plus get $2,250 purchase bonus cash on the specially equipped 2015 Enclave.
I'm excited to use HydroxyCut because I really want to lose weight.
Hey, we're gonna live free.
I lost 40 pounds. HydroxyCut really works.
HydroxyCut is America's number one selling weight loss supplement brand.
Lose weight your way.
Mix and match gummies, tablets, and drink mix.
Don't let more years go by and continue to pack on the pounds. Start as soon as you can.
HydroxyCut lets you lose weight your way. And look for new HydroxyCut Appetite Control to help curb hunger for hours.
When it comes to food, pets know what they want, and so do we. That's why you'll find simple, natural ingredients like real meat and wholesome veggies in delicious Rachael Ray Nutrish recipes. With no fillers or byproducts, and Rachael's personal proceeds from Nutrish help shelter pets everywhere.
Guys, I said I'd be back.
Give your pets the food they would make for themselves, if they could. Rachael Ray Nutrish. Real recipes, real ingredients, real good.
Time to sweat, boys. Big time.
Let's get this thing right.
I have made fire!
A new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, tonight at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 87 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray afternoon or evening thunderstorm is possible. High 89. Tonight, scattered thunderstorms early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Winds south at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Tomorrow morning, heavy summer rains bring out the snakes. Which ones are dangerous, and do you know the difference? Plus, the forecast to start your week tomorrow on AMHQ. The hour. Hope you're having a great Sunday. Weekend Recharge rolls on. I'm Maria LaRosa.
And I'm Alex Wallace. Now, as always on Weekend Recharge, we like to see how the weather is impacting communities. That's big and small. And one of the best ways to find out what's going on is by checking out the local newspapers.
That's right. So let's begin with the Reporter newspaper in Fond du Lac, Wisconsin. And this front page article is all about the heat. Despite the temperatures in the 90s yesterday, the hot weather did not impact the attendance for their 164th Fond du Lac County Fair.
And here's a look at the front page of the Kansas City Star. Now, this article is about a new NASA project. Scientists there spent between June 1st and July 15th flying above sections of Kansas, Nebraska, Oklahoma, and Texas, collecting data before and during nighttime thunderstorms in order to learn more about how they form and how they become severe and how to predict them a little bit more accurately. Maria?
All right, let's take a look at today's top stories because we're going to get you ready, recharge for today, but also give you a sneak peek at what you can expect as you start the week tomorrow. And we're definitely talking about severe weather. Huge threat area from Colorado all the way into New England. It's wind, it's heavy rain, and it's not going to stop it today. We'll see that continue tomorrow. We'll talk about the timing. And we all know the heat is here right now. Looking at later today, those heat index values above 100 degrees all the way from Kansas City and, yes, even into the New York metro. Heat emergency in effect for D.C. We'll time out the heat for those areas because there will be some relief in the short term. Not so much the rainfall in the southwest and the west. Maybe not a bad thing, but for Southern California, it could mean more flash flooding, certainly in the southwest as well. Interesting tropical connection continues here. We'll time that out as well. But first, Alex, you're talking about storms.
Yeah, absolutely. And of course, with those storms, you get a bit of a lightning. And lightning and planes, some surprising facts here for us as we open up the floor here in the lab. On average, most commercial airplanes are actually struck by lightning at least once per year. Now, modern airplanes, they're made of a composite material that doesn't do too well with conducting electricity. By the way, older planes, typically aluminum, did just fine with conduction, so that lightning just flowed along the exterior of the plane with no issues. But to account for the non-conducting material in those newer planes, there's actually a thin metallic mesh, maybe a few thousandths of an inch thick, woven into the plane's skin, and this is what allows the electrical energy from the lightning to flow through, which keeps the aircraft safe. So you're okay in the plane, even with thunderstorms out there. Now, we've got stormy weather out there on the move from parts of the plains into New England. We look live now at two spots in the crosshair, Chicago as well as Buffalo. Chicago's starting to see a few more clouds around, but still quiet now. Buffalo, blue skies, and you'd be thinking, wow, it's going to be a beautiful day, and most of it should be, but there is the risk for storms coming in later on today. Right now, it's right in the middle of the country. You can see the showers and storms that are in place here, mainly northern parts of Missouri, into portions of Illinois as well. We've seen some heavy downpours, which has led to flash flood warnings in a number of spots. Some of the 12-hour rainfall estimated totals here getting up close to 6 inches here in northern Missouri. So it's that kind of rain which is leading to some of these flash flood warnings. It's a turn around, don't drown situation in some spots, including in and around New Salem here, a county road here, two collapsing due to flash floods here. So, yeah, that can happen, too, out there as well. So let's follow all this activity activity. Here's our front, which is going to continue to move its way on off towards the east, sparking off and kicking off some storms through the eastern lakes later today. As we get towards the evening, Buffalo heads up there, then eventually heading towards the east coast. And we'll also see some more showers and storms right across the Midwest try to redevelop. And some of those could be severe. Anywhere in the red, right along Interstate 70, will follow you, Salina to Kansas City, St. Louis as well. Damaging wind, hail, main threats, but can't rule out the isolated tornado. And we also watch for the threat for some spotty damaging wind and hail from the Ohio Valley all the way into portions of the Northeast. So active times across a good chunk of the middle of the country towards the east. Now, Boston, here's how things will play out for you. Storms generally after 5 o'clock here for you. Main threat will be the damaging wind out there for you, as well as that lightning. Could be frequent and, of course, very dangerous. Looks like by the overnight, Boston, most of those storms should come to an end there for you. But we're not done. Tomorrow, still the risk for some storms. We move back into the middle of the country, St. Louis, another day with some of the stormy weather, moving back into parts of Kentucky, even a little bit farther south now. A spot like Knoxville may be dealing with some of these storms. And again, we'll watch the skies. Not very widespread, but storms that'll be capable of producing some damaging wind as well as hail. And then on top of that, we've got some heat issues too. Maria?
We absolutely do. It's our other big story, Alex. 73 million people nationwide under some kind of heat alert. It's so hot. Viral video sensation Eric Cornell, Mr. H-H-O-T-T himself, speaking out on the brutal conditions. This is, yeah. He's so upset, he can't even find the voice, his inner voice. No, but we're obviously having a bit of a technical issue. The good news is we're talking to Eric live in a few minutes, so we'll get it straight from him. But it is brutally hot. It is dangerous hot. That is no joke for sure. We're looking live at D.C. Heat emergency in effect. City officials have their plan in place, and they're also urging folks not to bust open their fire hydrants to cool off, because that can put the fire folks at risk for saving lives there. And, of course, Philadelphia under excessive heat warning. So basically, you've met the criteria where that heat and humidity combination will send that heat index way too high. 94 today in Philadelphia, 90 degrees in New York. Talk about D.C., and we mentioned the peak, right, when we talk about the high temperature. But this tells the story of why the heat is so dangerous. Above 100 degrees, that heat index from noon in D.C. until after 8 o'clock. That is where the danger comes in. So even after the sun begins to set, it's still holding on to that heat. Philadelphia kind of in the same boat here. Heat index over 100 by about noon, 1 o'clock. And you see not until later this evening, and really even into 9 o'clock, Alex, we have that heat index forecast to stay into the 90s. And their heat's not breaking. Even tomorrow will be another 90-degree day.
Yeah, that's one of the big issues. In fact, main issues is the fact that at night when you get into these heat situations, things just don't cool down. Well, the summer monsoon and tropical moisture swamping the likes of Phoenix and L.A. Some incredible scenes ahead.
Plus, he's back. We're checking in with Eric Cornell as he, along with 73 million of us, try to deal with this scorching heat.
I feel his pain.
I do too.
Introducing Teavana Mango Black Tea Lemonade, only at Starbucks.
You're my buddy, my pal, my friend. It will be that way until the end. And wherever you go, I want you.
Making the most out of every mile. That's why I got a Subaru Impreza.
Love. It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
This little guy is about to make his first deposit.
We'd like to open up a savings account for him.
Yes. Great.
Thanks to mom and dad and their...
Oh, look at this. Safe driving bonus.
Are you safe driver?
Lucky little fella.
Only Allstate gives you 2 safe driving bonus checks a year for driving safe. See how much more an Allstate agent can do for you. Call 877-644-3100.
Like in most families, Dad's always the last to know.
Oh,
That's why accident forgiveness was the first thing he asked for when he switched to Allstate.
Michael James?
Middle name. Not good.
Get accident forgiveness from Allstate and keep your rates from going up just because of an accident. Find out how a local Allstate agent can help better protect your family. Call one right now. Plus, drivers who switch saved an average of $498 a year.
Just a few more ways the good hands are doing more than ever before.
See what the personal service of an Allstate agent can do for you. Call 877-644-3100.
Let's do a reality check. Kids will be kids. Dogs will be dogs. So let's get some paint that's more than just paint. Made to stand up to this and look beautiful for years. Let's lose the old marks and messes and stop new ones in their tracks. Let's worry-proof our walls. Let's do this. Behr Ultra Interior with advanced stain blocking, just $29.98. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
What's this?
A box. I take worn-out things and makes them better.
It's our biggest breakthrough yet. We're taking worn-out batteries and making them into something strong. Energizer Eco Advanced, world's first long-lasting battery made with 4% recycled batteries.
Hey, America. Still not sure whether to stay or go to your people?
Should I stay or should I go?
Well, this summer, stay with Choice Hotels twice and get a $50 gift card you can use for just about anything.
Go.
You always have a choice. Book now at choicehotels.com.
Currently in our area, 88 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray afternoon or evening thunderstorm is possible. High 89. Tonight, scattered thunderstorms early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Winds south at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Just a stunning scene in Arizona. Torrential rain in the Phoenix area sent floodwaters roaring through a normally dry area. The water washed away cars, RVs, homes. Parts of the Phoenix region got 2 inches of rain in just half an hour. Meanwhile, in parts of Southern California, a record-breaking Saturday for rain. Downtown Los Angeles set a record yesterday with 0.3 inches of rain. All right, think how much that is in your area. Well, the month's half over, and already it is the wettest July on record in downtown Los Angeles. All right, here in Atlanta, a city known for its traffic jams, also got heavy rain. It rained so hard at times it shut down lanes and stalled traffic on Interstate 285. Although, Alex, this could be, you know, I don't know, Friday afternoon, any day of the week.
You said it. You could at any hour of the day as well. It doesn't matter in Atlanta. It seems like it's always trafficy. All right, let's talk about what's going to be happening with the storms, because we do have quite a bit of that here for today. Middle of the country moving into the northeast. Wide zone of potential severe storms. That includes you in Buffalo, Cleveland to Pittsburgh, back towards Salina, Kansas. Damaging wind and hail, we'll watch out for those main risks, but a chance for tornado can't rule that out. Now in Kansas City, here's how we're looking right now. Generally seeing some sunshine out there, some clouds, no doubt, with temperatures in the upper 70s. As we progress on through the day, well, there is that potential for more storms to try to sneak in this afternoon, as well as we get in towards this evening. So heads up there. Moving our way towards Cleveland, where right now along Interstate 90, we're looking at things here. Fairly quiet. In fact, some sunshine mixing in with some clouds. Mostly cloudy, at least being reported at the airport, but it's dry. That, though, that could change out there for us as we move our way through the afternoon. There we are, late in the evening, watching some of those storms try to sneak on in, 9 to about 11 o'clock. Generally hit and miss, so we'll watch some of those stormy conditions impacting you there. And then our last stop takes you to Indianapolis, where we are at 80 degrees right now, some cloudy skies. As we move through the day, here's how you'll fare, storm potential throughout. Maria?
All right, Alex, one city feeling the heat today. Certainly Memphis, Tennessee. Are you ready for this? Forecasting a high of 99, but it's going to feel like 108. heat advisory remains in effect until 7 o'clock Central Time.
All right. Unfortunately, that is not the news viral video sensation and our good friend Eric Cornell wants to hear. He's in Memphis, Tennessee, and he posted this new video on YouTube just a few days ago.
Something's wrong. I don't know what's happening, but baby, it's too hot out here. H-H-O-T-T. In Memphis, Tennessee, yes, God, it is hot. South Carolina, you must be getting a break because hell has shown up over here.
Oh, and Eric joins us this morning. I would ask you how you're enjoying the heat. Are you wearing a sweater, sir, by the way?
No, it's definitely not a sweater for sure. It's light.
Okay, good. Okay. Phew. All right, so how are you doing? You're joining us from the car. I hope the AC is on.
Yeah, I'm at the scene of the crime, and my air conditioner is on 1,000 below zero. You can, right here, I promise you that. It is so hot. You know, it's so hot. I remember my grandmother would say, boy, it's so hot out there, you've been caught the sugar. But it is so hot. You know, one while I was praying for rain, but man, the rain is so hot, it feels like, you know, little pieces of people throwing hot rice at you. You know,
it's
wow.
Hot. Yowzers.
Hot.
Now, Eric, your last video was in Columbia, South Carolina. Do you see any difference between the heat there and where you are there in Tennessee?
Tomato, tomato. It's about regardless, you know? It's like, is it 350 or 355? I mean, hot is hot, man. Hot is hot, okay?
All right, I got to ask you in about 30 seconds, what's your plan to stay cool? You're going to stay in that car all day?
Well, I'll probably take a shower all day long and drink ice water in the process.
We love that you hydrate. That is excellent information. All right. Sweet. We're going to get you that forecast, Eric. Thanks for joining us again. We know it's going to be hot. We've added an extra H and an extra T, by the way, to your hot. But you can see that heat index staying above 100 straight on through this evening.
Oh, that is just brutal stuff indeed. I tell you, I don't blame him. I'm in the car always complaining about the heat myself.
I know. He does look a little confused. we'll get to fall someday, Eric. We will. We love you, buddy. Hang in there. So much more to come on Weekend Recharge.
That's the Trauma Unit 5. What do we got?
BP 64 reporting.
Two units of
O-9.
Multiple foreign objects in the body.
Cruisers.
If you're the guy from the operation game, you get operated on. It's what you do. If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to GEICO. It's what you do.
You know, today could be your special day, a day that matters, a day that helps you change your life. But first, I want to introduce you to someone I think you know, Marie Osmond.
Hey, Kathy!
I want people to know that it's possible, that finally there is somebody out there who can help you, and the program is unique, yes. And there's a lot of extra things we're going to talk about that it's going to be so exciting.
Great.
It's the best program out there.
Lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's Fast 5 Plus Kit. Lose 5 pounds in your first week, plus 1 inch off your waist or your money back, guaranteed.
We have a special surprise today, a real Nutrisystem success story. Corey, come on out.
Corey!
You look fabulous. How much have you lost?
I lost 30 and a half pounds.
That half counts.
So here's the big question I get asked all the time. How has it changed your self-esteem?
I'm in my 40s, and so I figured, well, it's all downhill from here. I'm not going to ever look any better than I did then. And I do. I feel 20 years younger.
Order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now, including Fast 5 Plus. Get 1 week of specially selected meals, plus 1 week of energizing shakes to rev your metabolism, free. And 1 week of the all-new NutriCrush shakes to crush your hunger, free. Order now and get FedEx shipping, free.
This is a 28-day starter packet. Check it out. We have Italian herb flatbread pizza, thick crust pizza, chicken Alfredo, all of this. And then, but wait, there's more.
The best part, purple.
Purple's dessert. I would never be happy if I didn't have my cookies, my brownies, the bars. You get all kinds of choices. You always have food. You are never hungry. So you get all of this, 28 days, basically open the box and have a fiesta.
Don't wait. The phone lines are open and the reps are standing by. So call right now.
Call 888-420-SIZE right now and get Fast 5 Plus with Shake Spring.
A new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, tonight at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Great time for a shiny floor wax, no?
Not if you just put the finishing touches on your latest masterpiece. Timing's important. Comcast Business knows that. That's why you can schedule an installation at a time that works for you, even late at night or on the weekend if that's what you need, because you have enough to worry about. I did not see that coming.
Don't deal with disruptions. Get better internet installed on your schedule. Comcast Business, built for business.
I'm Robert Voorhees. At Synergy Health and Wellness, we are dedicated to improving the quality of life of our patients. If you or someone you know has urinary incontinence, you know that the frequent and urgent need to get to the bathroom can put limits on your enjoyment of life. Our new non-surgical, non-invasive nerve stimulation therapy can bring freedom and security back to those desperate to reclaim their active lives. Call us today or visit synergyofjupiter.com. Take charge of your health.
Currently in our area, 88 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray afternoon or evening thunderstorm is possible. High 89. Tonight, scattered thunderstorms early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Winds south at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Just a stunning sight for folks not really used to much rainfall, right? The rain came down heavily in Buckeye, Arizona.
Yeah, 2 inches of rain in just a half an hour. Quite a bit there yesterday in parts of the Phoenix area. Thanks to one of our viewers, Daniel Orzel, for the video. He posted it on Facebook. And we're still not sure what we're looking at.
I'm thinking maybe rooftop, perhaps? Or, we're not sure. But we can hear it. There's a lot of rain.
Well, during monsoon season, you get the dry westerly winds reverse direction and then become a bit more easterly. And it's that shift that can produce a lot of rain in the southwest over a very short period of time.
And Sam Champion explains why in this edition of Brainstorm, the wow behind weather.
The word monsoon, contrary to popular belief, is not just another saying for heavy rain. It's actually a seasonal wind shift that brings moisture to an otherwise dry region. And that's what produces the large storms that can drown parts of India in almost 2 billion gallons of rain per square mile over a 3-month-long monsoon season. But monsoons don't just drench India. They're also an annual event in North America, where in the desert southwest, they can deliver more than 50% of the region's annual rainfall in only about 12 weeks. It all happens in the summer, when the temperatures in the southwest can top 110 degrees. The heat combines with the bone-dry desert air. Humidities there can be 20% or lower, causing the air density to drop and produce an area of low pressure. Because air naturally rushes into zones of low pressure, the cool high pressure systems over the Gulfs of Mexico and California begin to pump north, bringing tropical moisture right into the southwest. The result? An unstable atmosphere that can generate the types of thunderstorms bringing double-digit rainfall over the summer. In fact, the southwestern monsoon has at times dumped as much as 80 billion gallons of water over Phoenix alone. That's 3 times more rainfall than the famously soggy city of Seattle gets during the same 3-month time period. Add it all up, and that much water is roughly the equivalent of the total water consumption of Phoenix for 9 months. And now you've been brainstormed. Sam Champion, The Weather Channel.
All right, so you heard a lot of water can come down. Mm-hmm. And so with any showers and thunderstorms, usually flash flood watches are posted, and that's exactly what we find again today. Includes also parts of Southern California, the LA area, Palm Springs, Las Vegas, Yuma. So that means conditions are favorable to see water rise really quickly in some of the waterways or the roadways.
And the thing is, we're not expecting, huge, copious amounts of rain here, but it doesn't take much in this part of the world to really run into some problems. We saw that yesterday with some of those storms that impacted us there in Arizona. So again, it doesn't take much to cause issues.
All right, we also have a severe weather threat, not in the Southwest, but parts of the Midwest and the Central Plains, Salina, Kansas City, St. Louis, over into Indianapolis, and really even into the Northeast. We're talking that heavy rain, but gusty winds. Watch for that this afternoon, especially in the Northeast and New England. And they're not really going to cool you off a whole lot. Another day of hot weather in the Northeast tomorrow, too.
Absolutely. Well, coming up, something that you do not want to miss. Two words for you, surfer, shark.
Two more words, shark. Attack.
Yeah, and this is caught on camera live. You don't want to miss it. Incredible video.
You ever think about how the cement of your driveway connects to the ends of the earth? From roller coaster hills to musical streets and movie chase scenes, it's all one road. Everywhere you take it tells your story. And wherever you are is where the road begins. The Camry. Toyota. Let's go places.
Why would you need a backpack that's backed by a guarantee? LL Bean Backpacks. Guaranteed for all the things life and kids throw their way. Designed smarter, built tougher.
Still paying too much for home phone service? Do the math. Magic Jack costs only $35 a year for unlimited local and long distance calling to the US and Canada. And with the mobile app, get unlimited text messaging.
Unlimited texting for iOS only.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is a large and dangerous tornado.
That's why we get real local the moment you need it.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas, Mississippi, Florida.
Real accurate.
This is round one of the severe storms that are coming through.
From real experts on the ground.
That is a gust front for you right there in Dusty, Texas. Wow.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is basically what makes the Weather Channel.
Keep the Weather Channel on.
Here at the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel is out in full force today.
Only the Weather Channel.
Just about 5 minutes for the top of the hour. Let's give you an update on the tropics. And we have remnant low Dolores, final advisory on this system. But you can see a broad circulation with the satellite. Still having an impact on Southern California with the rip current risk and the wave. But the official track still taking that center of the low pretty close to California. Meanwhile, our focus is going to be back into the eastern Pacific for what could be the next one. Next name on the list, by the way, Felicia. You've got a pretty decent, healthy looking satellite picture here with this disturbance of Invest 99E, 90% chance of further development. So that's pretty much a guarantee that we're going to see something official out of this. And that area where we could see that development looking favorable. So a couple of things you look for, the warm water temperature, but also low shear. And it looks like we've got that working towards it. And speaking of working towards, here we are July in the Atlantic season, peaking in early to mid-September. So still a long way to go in the Atlantic season. Still a long way to go as far as the numbers game here. It's been really, really quiet. A lot of dry air has led to not really a lot of tropical development or any hint of it. But looking at climatology, storm origins for mid-July, kind of all over the place from the Gulf of Mexico, southeast coast. But we get to see some of that development a little bit further out into the Atlantic. That's where we start looking this time of year for tropical waves to see if anything looks favorable. And at this point, we do see some tropical waves, but nothing that really is threatening. Anything officially. So we'll keep you posted.
All right. And what Dolores winding down the Pacific. That's my mother-in-law's name.
Oh,
so
okay.
I have to give her a big shout out.
Dolores.
All right, something amazing here. Pretty crazy, Ashley, to tell you about that's trending on the social medias.
Oh, we do want to warn you, though. It is kind of scary, and we don't say that lightly. It really is. This happened in South Africa. We'll go ahead and tell you everything is okay. That's where Australian surfer Mick Fanning waiting to catch a wave during a live televised surfing competition when he was attacked by a shark. Look at this.
Look at the
right
fin.
There.
Look at the fin.
Right there.
Wow.
And look at him. He's like, I'm out of here. He was okay. The short fight with the shark, he won there, right? The surfing competition was canceled, and the broadcast went on, and thankfully they took the camera wide, right, because they didn't know exactly what was going on, and they were able to go in and get there and get him out of the water.
But, I mean, how crazy is that?
And look how big that guy looked, or
wow.
gal.
You want to talk about a lucky individual?
Oh, my gosh.
This could have ended horribly, but, yeah, he ends up being just fine.
And, you know, South Africa, that's great white sharks like to hang out there. But that's one of those things where surfers kind of know that risk going in there. But, my goodness, to capture that on live TV, look at him. From what I understand, too, we were listening to it before, it looks like it might have gotten the cord that, you know, is attached.
Oh,
that was cut. That was bitten off.
Wow.
Yeah, he is lucky.
And, of course, the competition. Shut down.
Yeah,
rightfully
for good
so.
Reason. Well, thank you so much for joining us on Weekend Recharge. We're going to leave you with your heart rate up.
Right.
Hope you have a great day. Weather Geeks is coming up next. And Alex, thank you for a great weekend filling in.
Oh, thanks for having
so
me.
Much
it was
fun.
Always fun.
Have a great day.
Currently in our area, 89 degrees under part. Today, partly cloudy. A stray afternoon or evening thunderstorm is possible. High 89. Tonight, scattered thunderstorms early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Winds south at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Weather Geeks, can you believe it's been a year? 45 shows, 72 guests, and more than 100 topics tackled. As you look back on our year, one question just wouldn't go away.
Susan, the forecasts are pretty good, but what are our challenges in terms of messaging it?
Well, I think one of the big challenges, Marshall, in terms of messaging, especially about weather, is that the media landscape is so cluttered with so much information, and people carry their mobile devices around. We are exposed to so many, a sea of messages that we live in, that most of us have developed a kind of defense mechanism to block much of it out. So getting through that clutter, I think, is one of the very first biggest challenges.
Right, and we'll deal a little bit also with the other aspect, the social media-rologist as well, and some of the challenges there. Kim, sort of, as we get this discussion started, what do you see as some of the big challenges as we start to think about social sciences? And I know there are even some issues using that term.
There are a number of challenges, but I think one of our goals is to help bridge this gap between how meteorologists understand the weather and relate to it and how their audiences do. And part of communication is an exercise in mutuality and understanding the perceptions, values, beliefs, attitudes, and experiences of those you want to communicate with. And we've started as a scientific community making technology better so that we can detect tornadoes, so that we can predict the intensity of hurricanes. And now we're actually in the enviable position where we can start thinking about how it is that we relate to the people that we want to talk to, who we want to influence.
Well, we had a lot of issues. You know, part of our problem, Marshall, it's hard to deal with multiple tornadoes that look like that at the same time. Do you discriminate against somebody because they live in the country? If you've got one coming through a larger city like Tuscaloosa or Birmingham, what makes a human life less valuable? So there's not a manual on how to do that. And part of the other problem we had was we know now we've got to get a live camera on as many tornadoes as we can.
And by the way, James's coverage is legendary. Look, his coverage of this event should be 101 in any broadcast meteorology class. Sorry to interrupt you, but I just wanted to set the stage here, showing you some of your legendary coverage. Continue.
Right. what we've learned, and you're seeing a debris ball on television.
Yes.
For those of us in the science world, we see a Hooke echo and a debris ball and reflectivity. We see a velocity couplet. We see on the new dual polarization products, on the correlation coefficient product, yes, this tornado debris signature. We didn't have that back in 2011, but we have that now.
Absolutely.
What we've learned is that as strong as we try and communicate that, people see a bucket of spill paint. We have to be better in the broadcasting world of getting cameras on tornadoes. They will respond to that.
Advisories, watches, warnings. I mean, my mom, my cousin, they sometimes get confused about what the difference is. And I know there was discussion about being downgraded. I mean, from a communication standpoint, what's the challenge there?
That really is it, though. It's the communication was really the problem, not so much as the forecast, isn't it?
Yeah, the forecast was good enough for them to be aware that there was a problem and we shouldn't have all those people on the road. The perception among many people, including in the state and local government, was that going from a watch to an advisor was a downgrade, but also because the snow amount difference was just slightly less in the advisory, where advisory, and I mean, this is your department, but advisory actually means that you think something's going to happen, right? And the watch means that it might happen, but it's a confidence interval thing.
Set on slightly different criteria.
So, right. It really comes down to communication.
From an emergency management perspective, do you offer an opinion on whether we should have a consistency in terms of how we message threats?
Well, I think it would be helpful because for the public, the worst thing that can happen is hear two different versions of the same event coming based upon which channel they tune to. So we'd like to have consistency, but I think part of this is also, which is really your expertise, how do we communicate the uncertainty of risk and that we may need to prepare for something that may not be the high probability, but if it does occur and you haven't taken steps, could have bad consequences.
We have to be on the same page. I don't believe we should have proprietary indices. I don't believe everybody should have different call to actions during a tornado. We've got to be on the same page, and as a weather enterprise, we have to get together and work on this. You started a remarkable thing during your year as president of the AMS. Remarkable. You reached out to all the members of the weather enterprise. We have to keep that ball rolling. And not that we're going to say the exact same words, sure, but the message has to be the same.
And Administrator Fugate, I want to come to you because part of the discussion now has been, should our forecast have some degree of uncertainty with it? There's even been discussion of should we have cones of uncertainty like we do with hurricanes. Would that kind of information help you as an emergency manager?
Well, we already have that. That's why it's called a forecast and not a fact.
We've termed social meteorologist on this show because there's so much information out there on social media. Rick, you use social media. You're the master of it, I think, in terms of the National Weather Service, at least. What's your philosophy?
You know, we think it's a tool to get the weather information out to as many different people as possible. If we get a warning to one person, they take action, or they share a post with a family member who takes action, then we've done our job. But it's it's not all fun and games. You know, there's people out there that are making it more complicated. There's people that are.
What do you mean?
Well, there are. Well, we don't have enough time, but there are different. There's people out there who are meteorologists who are putting out conflicting information. People that aren't meteorologists putting out conflicting information. And again, people looking for that consistent message. Sometimes they don't know what to do when they see, well, this guy is saying it's going to be the worst tornado outbreak since the beginning of time, and the other three guys are saying nothing. So it's given us a lot more opportunities, a lot more venues to talk about weather information, but it's also opened up the door to get a lot of misinformation in there and some bad stuff going on.
Watch versus warning.
Yeah.
Now, I argue that those words are too close. They confuse people.
But let's imagine.
Yeah.
Okay. We suddenly decided instead of we're going to call a watch, we're going to call it a Knutenary.
Okay.
And instead of a warning, we're going to say it's a Chinkadera.
Okay.
Do you honestly think that we're going to convey meaningful information to the public with changing the words?
Yeah, I think there were certain.
Are the words really that similar?
Right. Yeah.
I want to go off on this.
Yeah,
one
please
a
do.
Bit.
This is why we have you
this
here.
This one really bugs me.
Yes.
The Wawa problem has been talked about
watch
for decades.
Watch versus warning.
Right. And the problem with that is that nobody has really done any serious studies on how bad an effect those two words starting with WA really is. Is it really that bad?
Right.
And if it is, what would we have to do to fix it?
So in other words, what's the alternative if this is broken?
And in my opinion, one of the points I want to make is that the Weather Service watch warning program is not broken.
Right.
It has been proven over the decades to be a very effective system.
Okay.
When I was a boy back in the Stone Ages, that is the 1950s, there were hundreds of people every year dying in tornadoes. If we have as many as 100 in a year, we call it a really bad year now.
Sure, sure.
And so to say that the warning watch program is broken is just wrong.
It was impossible to air 45 shows without getting into a little controversy. That's next on Weather Geeks.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your doctor about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
And then it hit. And you took it to the edge. Didn't give up.
Currently in our area, 89 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray afternoon or evening thunderstorm is possible. High 89. Tonight, scattered thunderstorms early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Winds south at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
On the Weather Channel.
Is that a new washing machine?
Yeah, it's a Samsung with Active Wash.
It's got a built-in sink to pre-treat and help get stains out. How about this?
The Samsung washing machine with Active Wash. Get 10% off select major appliances at Lowe's.
So, you say men are superior drivers?
Yeah.
Then how do I get this
safe driving bonus check? Every 6 months without an accident, Allstate sends a check. Okay. Silence. Are you in good hands?
When you're living with diabetes, steady is exciting. Only Glucerna has Carb Steady, clinically proven to help minimize blood sugar spikes. So you stay steady ahead.
Introducing Starbucks Small Batch Cold Brew Coffee, in stores now.
Welcome back to our one-year Weather Geek special. We welcome 72 guests in our first season, and Dr. Shepard was not shy about asking the tough questions.
I know you guys have some diverging viewpoints on how much humans may be contributing to, in terms of greenhouse gases versus land use change. Roger, what's your perspective on, I mean, you've been vocal in the community on some of these topics. What's your perspective on climate change right now?
Well, first of all, I think climate's always been changing for natural reasons. And so I think the word climate change is actually misleading us a little bit. We need to be worried about climate in general. Uh-huh. It's always presented risks.
Okay.
What can we do given today's infrastructure and population to reduce that risk? I think that's one issue. Second, we have to recognize that the human role on the climate system is real, but it's more diverse and complex.
Let's get that on camera. You said it is real.
Yes.
So I want to kind of dispel some notions about you out there. Okay.
Yeah, climate, humans definitely exert. In fact, it's really easy. And you're here in Phoenix, for example. We go outside in Phoenix and there's buildings
urban,
and makes it hotter, as you well know from your research, makes it much hotter than it used to be.
Sure.
CO2 is one of them, but it's not the only one. In many cases, it may not be the most dominant one. So I think that's the issue. It's a more complicated problem than how it's been generally presented.
Now, siren mentality, it's killing people. Why in the world are we using World War I technology in 2014? You can't hear them inside a building. You can't hear them in a studio. You can't hear them in a school. You can't hear them in a church. You can't hear them in a business. And yet it seems like most of the population thinks you're going to hear one of these things. You cannot. You should never, ever rely on these things. I am so frustrated.
Yeah,
I want to climb these poles, take the stinking things down and burn them. And that way, you know you won't hear one.
Right. I think the Hurricane Center and the Weather Service meteorologist at Mount Holly had a pretty good handle on this. And then you've got the mayor, a key leader, as you talked about in your book, that could have set the tone but didn't, missed an opportunity. Do you see that in your research? Was that across the board with policymakers and stakeholders? Did some kind of get it or get it later? What was your experience there with the research?
New York was really anomalous. And for me, that was the most chilling moment in the book.
The largest populated area in the region.
With a lot of resources, but a lot of confusion. Everyone I talked to, both in the mayor's office and the New York City of Emergency Management, just described it as the fog of war. They said we were confused. We were getting information from the National Weather Service in Upton instead of the National Hurricane Center. They said Irene, so we thought it would be fine. And you see this very sort of strange press conference where Mayor Bloomberg is saying everything is going to be fine. And of course, we know now it wasn't.
I want to put it bluntly, yeah, I guess. The fact is, the Weather Channel has gone ahead to name winter storms, frankly, because we can. We're set up for this. This is, and again, I come from the government side, the National Weather Service, 30 years of work there. But on the Weather Channel side, we are covering weather on a national scale. We not only cover weather on a national scale, we have the technology to cover that weather and the technology to communicate information about that on many different platforms.
Well, speaking of controversy, recently the National Weather Service, there was a proposal in the U.S. Senate to consolidate Weather Service offices down. I think it was something on the order of 6 offices. Now, I think that they've backed away from that some. But
right.
What's your thought on that?
Well, I think them backing away from it was quite predictable. I don't think there's enough political support for that kind of draconian trimming of the Weather Service. Some colleagues of mine and I wrote an article a number of years ago proposing a similar sort of reduction in staffing and concentration in a smaller number of centers. But one of the big issues that confronts the Weather Service is public outreach.
Right.
And it's virtually impossible to conduct any meaningful public outreach when the person doing it is 150, 200, 300 miles away.
We've tackled serious issues and had some fun along the way. Our favorite season one moments next on Weather Geeks.
Think fixing your windshield is a big hassle? Not with Safelite. This family needed their windshield replaced, but their daughter's heart was set on going to the zoo. So we said, if you need Safelite to come to the zoo, we'll come to the zoo.
Oh yeah, we can fix that.
Only Safelite can fix your windshield anywhere in the U.S. with our exclusive mobile glass shops and our one-of-a-kind TruSeal technology for a reliable bond.
Thanks so much.
Service that fits your schedule. Hey. That's another Safelite advantage.
Safelite repair, Safelite replace.
In the nation, what's precious to you is precious to us. So when coverage really counts, you can count on Nationwide. We put members first. Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
These buttery croissant dogs are so gourmet and so French. Ah, yes, the old French mime trick. That's really gonna work.
Okay, no, no, no. No. Stop it. No. Haha, what do you think of that? Mm-hmm. You want me to rub your fingers with my...
Rub my fingers? You owe me money for my rope.
Ooh la la. Introducing the buttery French croissant dog. And don't forget our half-price shakes after 8 p.m. This is how you sonic.
Thompson's Water Seal Waterproofing Stain. The seal you can trust. With stain and sealer in one. And easy to choose colors. Exceptional beauty and protection have never been easier. Thompson's Water Seal Waterproofing Stain. Available at the Home Depot.
Amore.
Subito.
The all-new Fiat 500X crossover, featuring an available Uconnect system with a 6.5-inch touchscreen and available all-wheel drive. Well-rounded, has never looked so sharp.
We write, produce, and star in USA's comedy Playin' House.
But we still watch a lot of TV.
Jim Cantore, 3D Tornadoes.
I could watch that Sam Champion talk about weather all day long.
Oh, there's a storm a-coming.
And it's raining men.
Great! Let's add one more thing to your must-watch list.
Playing House is back with an all-new season August 4th at 10 on USA.
I have lung cancer.
And I've heard it all.
The well-meaning advice of friends.
The guarded words of doctors.
The brave resolve of loved ones.
What I haven't heard, what a lot of us haven't heard nearly enough,
is new news.
Over 430,000 Americans are living with lung cancer today. In fact, every 2.5 minutes, another person is diagnosed. Although there are known risk factors, anyone can get lung cancer, and every case is different. But now, patients could be hearing some unexpected news. This news goes beyond what you may know today. Research is leading to scientific advancements that could offer some patients the potential of longer life and the chance to share more moments and memories.
News in lung cancer? Now I'm listening.
If you have lung cancer, you haven't heard it all yet. Talk to your doctor today for more information on lung cancer. And call now or visit lungcancerinfo.org for a free patient education kit.
A new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, tonight at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 87 degrees, under mostly cloudy skies. Today, a mix of clouds and sun, a stray afternoon or evening thunderstorm is possible. High 89. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Partly cloudy skies, low 76. Monday, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Climate change and the government's role in weather. Those are two of the more serious issues tackled on Weather Geeks this year. We invited Dr. John Holdren, director of the White House Office of Science and Technology Policy, to discuss.
For our viewers that may not be familiar, what do you do? How often do you brief the president? What do you do in your various roles and as the nation's top science official, I would say?
Well, we have two big roles in the Office of Science and Technology Policy, and I as the president's science and technology advisor. One of those roles is to make sure the president and his other senior staff have the insights about science and technology that are germane to whatever policy issues are on their plate at the moment.
Yes.
So that might be technological innovation to drive economic progress and job creation. It might relate to biomedicine and public health. It might be energy and climate change. It might be the science and technology of national security and homeland security. Sure. We have to cover that whole space. We do it by drawing on not just the 125 people in my office, but all the scientists and engineers across the departments and agencies in the federal government. And if we can't find the expertise we need there to advise the president, we reach out into the wider community. Right. The academies of science and engineering and medicine, the university community, the private sector, to find the people who know what the president might need to know to make a good decision.
What you offer is just some hopeful words going forward to view. We have several viewers that watch this show. Weather Channel is quite well received in almost every home in America. What would you offer to the citizens of the United States in terms of hope?
That we have a window of time. I don't know how long it is, but I'm sure we have. We have to, first of all, become aware, and that's growing fast. But being aware isn't enough. We have to roll up our sleeves and do something about the way we live.
Yes.
So we have this youth program, Roots and Shoots, which actually goes along with what Captain Planet
is
doing.
Yeah, it's an amazing program. I've had the chance to study upon that.
And so all of our young people, you know, they're busy working on their parents and change the way we live. Just for a simple, ordinary person, think about the consequences of the small choices you make each day.
Yes.
I know my reasons for hope, the resilience of nature, nature coming back given a chance, animal species rescued, the human brain, all the amazing technology that will help us live in greater harmony if we use it.
That's correct.
And then in our own individual lives. And finally, the indomitable human spirit.
That is correct.
People who tackle the impossible and won't give up.
I just think it's important that we stop thinking about the term climate change as either political or inflammatory or negative, frankly. We just have to consider the fact that this is the natural order we're living in right now.
Right.
Whether it was natural or unnaturally created, it exists. We need to recognize it and deal with it. And the more people can understand that some of the weather events they're seeing really frame a pattern that's consistent with what we know a changing climate will bring, there are things that we need to do to prepare ourselves for it, to adapt, to be more resilient. And that's a focus of attention for the president's climate action plan as well.
It wasn't all serious stuff. We did have some fun.
I wish we could get your shoes in this particular shot.
Yeah.
You want to pop them up there? I don't know if you can reach it.
Oh,
look at this here. This is the first. So check out this. If this doesn't tell you how this guy, these are radar images here. Now, tell us a little bit about this shoe. I
mean, you know what? I'm a bit of a shoe collector, and you know, once I saw these, I had to have them. These are specifically foam posits that you know Penny Hardaway shoes.
Okay.
And they make all different types of designs, but they came out with this one, and I had to get my hands on them.
Now, I still to this day really don't know how I got this job.
Right.
I think there was a friend of a friend that worked here, and they were looking at where all these meteorologists were coming from out of college, and they just happened to see a tape of mine because at Linden State College we get to
hair,
do the
Jim,
weather.
It
was the hair. So the good news is I was hired when I had hair, not when I don't. But I prefer it like this, to be honest with you.
Absolutely.
But it's just been a great ride.
Thank you all for a great first year. We'd love to hear your thoughts on the show. So find us on Twitter and Facebook and get ready for another year of Weather Geeks.
All the things that happen on your wooden surfaces, disinfecting has to be one of them. Clorox disinfecting wipes.
Welcome to the sleep revolution. All new Emergen Z, a natural way to power down with melatonin plus vitamin C and other antioxidants to work their magic while you sleep. Don't just sleep, revitalize. New Emergen Z, power down to power up.
My goal is to finally get in shape. Not to be focusing on my moderate to severe chronic plaque psoriasis. So I finally made a decision to talk to my dermatologist about Humira. Humira works inside my body to target and help block a specific source of inflammation that contributes to my symptoms. In clinical trials, most adults with moderate to severe plaque psoriasis saw 75% skin clearance, and the majority of people were clear or almost clear in just 4 months.
Humira can lower your ability to fight infections, including tuberculosis, serious, sometimes fatal,
fatal infections and cancers, including lymphoma, have happened, as have blood, liver, and nervous system problems, serious allergic reactions, and new or worsening heart failure. Before treatment, get tested for TB. Tell your doctor if you've been to areas where certain fungal infections are common, and if you've had TB, hepatitis B, are prone to infections, or have flu-like symptoms or sores. Don't start Humira if you have an infection. Ask your dermatologist about Humira, because with Humira, clearer skin is possible.
Did you know only 1% of supplements have earned the USP mark, an independent certification for quality and purity? I recommend Nature Made because they've earned the most of any brand.
Nature Made, the number one pharmacist recommended letter vitamin brand.
Andrew. Rita. Sandy. Meet Chris. Jackie, Joe, minor damage or major disaster, when you need us most, we're there. State Farm, we're a force of nature too.
Food should be good. Strawberry should sing. Lettuce should be dirty. Dressing, clean. Debate should be healthy. Hatchets buried. Tables should be full. And good food should be good for you. We're not saying these are the rules we should all live by, but it's a good place to start. Panera, food as it should be. It's
your thing. See results in just 1 week with Slim Fast. Shake it off. Blend it off. Just take it off and keep it off. Rich, protein-packed Slim Fast controls hunger up to 4 hours. Slim Fast, it's your thing.
Three Scientists Walk Into a Bar is a show where we explain the weather.
Welcome to Awesome. This is all really badass.
There's no need to show up.
This is about how far you can push yourself.
I have made fire!
Currently in our area, 87 degrees, under mostly cloudy skies. Today, a mix of clouds and sun. A stray afternoon or evening thunderstorm is possible. High 89. Tonight, a stray shower. Monday, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is a large and dangerous tornado.
That's why we get real local the moment you need it.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas, Mississippi, Florida.
Real accurate.
This is round one of the severe storms that are coming through.
From real experts on the ground.
That is a gust front for you right there in Dusty, Texas. Wow.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is basically what makes the Weather Channel.
Keep the Weather Channel on.
We're at the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel is out in full force today.
Only the Weather Channel.
Glad you're with us right here on AMHQ, the whole team.
Right, either go all in or just tap out.
Here we go. I told you, we're going to bust out of this drought.
As we say, keep watching with us this morning because we're all watching history happen together.
Today's forecast, a tornado warning is in effect. Swarms of gigantic twisters over a wide area with winds topping 6,000 miles an hour. Luckily, you live outside the danger zone because these twisters are found in space.
With winds of 300,000 miles an hour.
What would happen if a tornado city on Earth?
It just goes poof, and it's gone.
They're tornadoes to the max on deadliest space weather. Earth's is just one kind of weather. On other planets, there are storms beyond the imagination, climates and conditions that we hope to never see on Earth. But could they happen here? And if so, could we survive deadliest space weather? It's late spring in the Lone Star State, peak tornado season. On this day, a monster twister descends from a giant thunderstorm. The immense funnel is 3 miles across. One of the most populated cities in Texas is in its path.
As this tornado moves towards Dallas, Dallas is going to experience something more powerful than anything that it could have imagined. About a quarter of the city will be laid waste.
The winds in this freak storm rage at 500 miles per hour.
One of the most startling sights we'd see is the destruction of the distinctive Reunion Tower. The top of it is going to just get blown off. It just goes, and it's gone. The tower itself would be pushed off its foundation and would likely fall all in one piece.
Fortunately, a tornado this big will never strike Dallas. This monster is what scientists think could be hiding on a newly detected world, strikingly similar to our own.
This is a planet that's about 1.5 times larger than the Earth in its physical size, and it's located at a distance from its parent star, which is very similar to the distance that the Earth is located from the Sun.
In early 2013, Kepler spacecraft scientists announced evidence for this super-Earth 2,070 light-years away. It may be the most Earth-like planet yet found.
We can imagine that it has continental areas that are flat and subject to strong cold fronts, as well as a warm, low-latitude sea that can provide masses of humid air. And so if those conditions exist there, then the conditions for strong tornadoes would also potentially exist.
The new planet might also have more tornadoes. Earth has 4 seasons due to the tilt of its axis. Most tornadoes strike in the spring when the sun heats the planet more or less evenly. If super-Earth has little or no tilt, it would have no seasons, with spring-like conditions all the time.
Without seasons, you might have the potential to build tornadic storms year-round. And so rather than just 1 of 4 seasons, maybe you have all 4 seasons that are capable of producing tornadoes.
On Earth, the maximum clocked tornado winds are about 300 miles an hour. We don't know the details of super-Earth's climate, but with the right balance of heat and atmospheric water, it's quite possible it could have super tornadoes as well.
Running the numbers on a back of the envelope kind of way, we can imagine tornadoes that are perhaps 2 or 3 times larger in physical size than the most damaging tornadoes that occur here on Earth. The wind speeds could potentially get up to the kinds of speeds that a passenger airline travels at. It could potentially get up towards 500 miles per hour.
But are Earth-like planets the only ones with tornado potential?
Any planet with an atmosphere could have a tornado. All you need are some swirling winds, some energy concentrated in a swirl, and you can get a tornado-like phenomenon.
The planet Mars is home to tornado-like dust devils, swirling vortexes of winds that create columns of powdery debris, zipping across the bleak landscape. Earth has its own dust devils. They reach a maximum height of 2/3 of a mile. On Mars, the biggest were thought to be 6 miles high. until a discovery in 2012.
The Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter shocked astronomers because it located a gigantic dust devil 12 miles tall.
But this dust devil was very narrow, 70 yards in diameter. NASA described it as three-quarters the size of a football field.
Imagine yourself sitting in a football stadium, and you've got this tornado three-quarters of the width of the stadium, and it's going up 12 miles high. So if you were to just go up, it would keep going and going and going. A very narrow, very high, swirling tornado of dust.
The solar system's giant planets might also produce tornadoes. Jupiter, Saturn, and Neptune are already known for their swirling clouds and hurricane-like storms. On Saturn, the Cassini spacecraft captured a photo of the planet's southern polar region, showing some twisted clouds that look familiar. They are intriguingly similar to the Doppler radar Hook echoes that are said to be signatures of tornadoes inside supercell thunderstorms on Earth.
I wouldn't be a bit surprised if one day we can nail it and say that this is, in fact, our tornado on Saturn. But right now, our instruments are not fine enough to make that conclusive judgment.
The largest tornadoes in the solar system occur not on its planets, but on the Sun. Astronomers have long known that the Sun produces huge prominences. The flashy tentacles of glowing gas that often erupt from the fiery surface. But in the last few years, new high-definition video from solar satellites has revealed prominences that turn into solar tornadoes.
They can be 5 Earth diameters wide and over 10 Earth diameters high, with winds of 300,000 miles an hour. So these are really monstrous things.
When the 11-year sunspot cycle hits a maximum, the big tornadoes on the Sun have something in common with their earthly counterparts.
On Earth, we have a tornado season. In some sense, the Sun also has a tornado season, especially with the 11-year sunspot cycle. When we have this burst of plasma emanating in space called solar prominences, they create tornadoes of their own. So we have a tornado season on the Sun.
Solar tornado season applies only to these giant monsters. The Sun is also home to a smaller kind of twister. But what happens when these tornadoes swirl into action? 11,000 at a time.
Hey, Mom.